And it's just like a heroin addict. Heroin addicts, yeah, if they don't take the drug, they get withdrawal symptoms. Yeah? They feel fucked. Yeah? They feel like they're going to die. Yeah? Heroin is a serious thing. I've been in, yeah, man, I don't talk too much, but man, been in certain environments. I've seen man chasing the dragon. Yeah? Man's got a piece of foil, yeah, puts the brown on it, yeah, puts the dark on it, puts the heroin on it, and they get a lighter and they run it underneath the foil, yeah, back and forth, yeah, and it heats up, obviously, the heroin, yeah, the dark, yeah. And as it evaporates, they chase the dragon, literally, chase the dragon. I'm actually talking about this in my book, because obviously, I was in certain situations before where man observed that, innit? Yeah, so, yeah. Or obviously they inject it or whatever, innit? Yeah. So, yeah, heroin is a serious thing. I used to live next to a fucking crack addict as well. Now, people then that do crack, they also do heroin as well. And I know this guy definitely done crack, yeah? For certain reasons I ain't gonna say, yeah? But, he was a healthy man back in the day, yeah? But he got hooked on the crack, and it just, he began to rot away, man, he began to rot away, man. Literally, the man started to deteriorate, yeah, these crack addicts, yeah, they start to lose their teeth, yeah, heroin addicts, they start to lose their teeth, they get really skinny, yeah, they don't even concern themselves with eating. Because crack, because heroin, because light, because dark, because white, because brown, that is their main focus. You know, they ain't interested in nothing else. They ain't interested in no gear, they ain't interested in no money. Well, they're interested in money because they need the money to go and get the food, yeah? Yeah, yeah, fam, they turn into nitties, bro. Blood. I've been in situations, been in environments where, and it's someone that lives a couple of doors down from my mum as well, yeah? A woman has to sell her body, because we know there's always beta males out here who are willing to pay for sex, yeah? Guys who can't attract women properly, yeah? Easily, should I say, yeah? Women, right? Sell their body to pay for drugs. Yeah? £10 for a blowers, yeah? £20 for a blowers, yeah? Not that I've ever been a recipient or nothing like that, but, yeah? In my mum's fucking area, Edmonton, yeah? Yeah? Plenty of crackheads around and, yeah, they're all prostitutes. Man? There was one gal on my street, yeah? Her mum still lives there right now, yeah? 13-year-old girl, yeah? She got pregnant, yeah? She got pregnant at 13, yeah? Obviously, the man was older than her, innit? Yeah? He could have all been 20 at the time, innit? I don't know, yeah? That ute now that she had is what? My younger brother's 21. He's 22, yeah? So that gal is what? Boom, 35, yeah? 35, 34, whatever, innit? Yeah? She wouldn't have been my type, yeah? But, you know, like there's certain girls, you can observe, okay, that girl is actually a cute looking girl, pretty looking girl. She ain't my type or whatever, yeah? Or she definitely ain't my type now because she a crackhead, isn't it? Yeah? But, you know, she was a cute girl back in the day. You could tell, yeah? When she was healthy, she would have been a cute looking girl, innit? Go out there and attract PM, bear man and that, innit? Yeah? She got hooked on crack probably at the age of 18 or something like that. She's fucked. Fucked. All the potential in the world, yeah? She could have been living in a nice house in little Essex, yeah? Driving a nice little white Range Rover, yeah? Good job, yeah? Maybe not no high-flying job, but, you know, earning like a, yeah, take home £4,000 a month, yeah? She could have been married, had 1-2 youths, little pet dog that don't stop fucking barking all day. Now, she ain't got none of that. All she got is the mindset to go out and get drugs, yeah? And in order to get the drugs, she has to sell her body. A man used to come to my estate in a fucking BMW X, I think it was X3, yeah? Old man, you know? Man all like 70 years old used to pick this girl up on a day-to-day basis, yeah? to take her out and do whatever with her, innit? You're selling your body to an old man, a man you wouldn't even spit on, a man you wouldn't even piss on if he was on fire, just for drugs. It's embarrassing. It's shameful. God forbid I ever had a child that was on, that turned to drugs. God forbid. Now, the man that used to live next to me, who was on drugs, he actually moved away. But I always said this one thing. When I have a child, if they ever even think, you know, I won't even wait for it. Man. When I have a child, if the guy was still living there, I would take that child, so long as they're old enough to understand. I ain't going to take a four-year-old, innit? When that child's like 13 or whatever, I'm going to take him to my mum's area and take him to that man's house and say, listen, if you ever even try a cigarette, yeah, this is what you're going to turn into, yeah? Because cigarettes, yeah, weed and that, yeah? Certain times weed is a gateway drug, yeah? Not for everyone. As I said, man, no man who's been burning weed for 20 years, yeah? To my knowledge, they don't do crack. But for some man, weed is a gateway drug. Yeah. You know, human beings, yeah, we always want to progress. Yeah. First of all, it's a cigarette, then it's weed, then it's crack and heroin, then it's crystal meth. Yeah. Crystal meth. I watched this program before, the world's most dangerous drug. Yeah? You think crack and heroin are bad? Crystal meth, different kind of drug. Yeah. Make you look like a fucking walking zombie. Yeah. You lose all weight. Yeah. Your mind is gone. You look like a fucking... You look like you're ready for a coffin. Yeah. You make dead people look alive. Yeah. You look so dead.